Alright, so here we are. I rustled me up some yum-yums. Look at that. It's all free for the food bank. I had some free barbecue sauce from Jack in the Box. I just put the stove on high, man. Pour the soup in. Heats up just like that. All you gotta do is keep stirring it. It won't burn on the pan. Otherwise, you put it on medium, you gotta wait 10 minutes. Shit, put it on high, it's done in three. I'm having a good time today, man. Practicing my, keep my head on swivel. Like I'm driving my car, man. I'm aware of what's around me. And I'm synchronizing it with my thoughts, listening, my ear, my eyes, expecting more and more. Can of peaches. Now, Stickum's coming back. I'm prophesying it right now. Stickum's coming back. I like Stickum better than Tiny Chat. Because Stickum, you could go into any room and the customers in there, or the people in there, had the option to shut your volume off, and you could keep your volume on, and you could do whatever you want and be as loud as you want, and you wouldn't disturb anybody. And you could tell stories and all that, and whoever wanted to listen to you, all they had to do was click into you. And you had a little monitor on the side that said how many people were listening to you. Yeah, Stickum was awesome. Stickum is awesome, man. It's coming back. I'm prophesying it right now. And I could record myself all at the same time, make videos while I was live, and post them on my YouTube also. As you can see, I gotta keep my beard clean sometimes. As I'm eating, I'm washing my thoughts, and I'm keeping aware of my surroundings. Watch the video that I made of guitar. It's a treadmill. I would do this on Stickum a lot. I love getting on camera and just eating my food, man. Talking at the same time. Just like being at the dinner table, man. I was the one that taught everybody on Stickum how to eat on camera. Everybody was ashamed and afraid to do it. Until I got on and started eating, everybody was like, oh shit, man, we can do it too.
Yeah.
had my favorite room that I went into, called the chillaxing room. It's cool because the creator of the room liked me, man. I can just be as free as I want, do whatever I wanted in there, man. Although sometimes the moderator would kick me out, but he never kicked me out. I got that guy's YouTube channel too. I can contact him if I want to. I'm one of those guys that gets on a trend, man, like on a tangent, and I just let everything get all messy and disorganized. I always end up, eventually, always cleaning it up, making it all nice and orderly again. But eventually, everything's going to start staying in order. See, if I speak it, I'm commanding it right now in the name of Jesus. I was listening to a guy on YouTube. His name was called Santos Bacotti, something like that. And he proved that through the ancient books that this dude Jesus never existed. Because he was reading from philosophers from the first century, and none of them mentioned anybody named Jesus that was on the earth. You would have figured that that dude would have been so popular, everybody would have wrote about him. Nobody wrote about him. That'll get your head thinking. This Jesus story was probably made up. Of course, because the book of the Bible is a story about commerce. Jesus is just a name that represents a corporation. I'm telling you. It's all coming together to me, man. It's funny how everybody believes that this dude Jesus actually existed, but they never checked the public records to see if he was ever in the public record. He's not there. So far, according to this dude that I read this book from, so kind of made sense to me, man. Kind of made sense to me. And the Vatican has all kinds of records that are hidden in the catacombs, so that just fuels to it that, well, someone might think, well, just maybe the records are actually down there in the Vatican, the catacombs. Well, let's pull them out and look then. I'm calling it out right now. All records in the Vatican's catacombs are coming out. Boom. Total transparency. It's coming. It's coming. Boom. Jesus' name. I told you. See, I all I got to do is speak it. It happens. at the Black Vatican. That's what Zach Wilde's all about, man. Ozzy Osbourne, the Wizard of Oz, the Straw Man, the Lion, the Tin Man, Zach Wilde, Black Wilde, the Cat Code, man. That's what it's all about, man. Total transparency. Peacefulness, safety. Do whatever you want to do. Trying to make yourself better. I just stretched my peripheral vision all around the earth. Instead of just around here in the neighborhood in the house, I just expanded my peripheral vision. I'm earthly now. I'm paying attention to that. I'm telepathically now. I'm connected with everybody around the earth. There it is. There's the power, man. I'm telepathic with everybody in the earth. I'm speaking with everybody on the planet right now. There we go. I've been there before. That's how I recognize it. Not just once, not just twice, many times. My awareness finally just came into play. So it was good that I started practicing my peripheral vision. Heavy. I'm talking to everybody on the earth right now. And everybody out in the spirit world. I'm aware of every single creature on the earth right now. They're aware of me. All because I'm thinking it. You can think your reality into existence, man. You just gotta get yourself in a space where you can do it so you're not working a job. So you can focus on long periods of time. You're not a security party creditor and you're into music and all that, well then you're a slave job to the band. You got to tour around the world all the time. That's just like having a job. That's not for me, man. I'm like George Lynch, man. ESP telepathic. Yes, we are Indians. Closed account, which means it's in the private, which means if anybody tries to look it up, it's not there. They'd have to go to the private attorney to see it. That's me. And anyone that I know, and anyone else that knows private maritime law, all they gotta do is see my lien in the public record to know that I can do anything I want. And this is safe, because it's a closed account with the U.S. Department of Transportation. All they gotta do is contact the U.S. Department of Transportation and see that it's a closed private account now. Down with your clowns, brother.